on that note, let's now march ahead to also introduce and invite our honorable chief guest for this evening. He heads the non-profit organization Wakad Foundation, which runs several programs in health, education, water, and sanitation across the breadth of the country. He's also the executive director of the Wakad Limited and part of the promoter family of the Wakad Group, a leading pharmaceutical and healthcare group. In fact, he's also the founder of the World Peacekeepers Movement, an online movement comprising of more than a million peacekeepers, forming the world's second largest army. Please put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, to welcome the chief guest of the evening, Sir Dr. Huzaifa Khorakiwala.
Good evening to all of you. It's my pleasure to be here at this Reality Plus conference. And this is the ninth edition of this conference. And they have been doing this for 9 years, and they are doing it in so many cities. And they bring all the real estate people together. And they give award and they recognize the good work that the real estate has done. So I congratulate the organizers of this conference and keep up the good work you are doing. Everyone needs recognition. And I would also like to congratulate all the winners that they will receive the award after this. And it is done, as our editor-in-chief has said, it is done in a very transparent and in a very honest manner, and that is very much required. These awards are a good platform for everyone to excel. And what the real estate industry requires, that every industry requires, industry is made up out of a lot of people. It's made up of thousands of business entrepreneurs, and all of them are working together and everything. So what the real estate industry requires is that it should be seen as an industry which is honest, which is transparent, and which stands for some good value, and it stands for something good. There are so many players, and everybody cannot act in the same manner as everyone. So sometimes some people are not following the exactly correct ethics and honesty, and the whole industry gets a little bad name because of that. So it is important that we have to see the real estate industry, that this industry should stand for good values, good ethics, honesty, transparency, and people can rely on this. And when the consumers can rely on the industry, it will help the industry will grow, and the business will grow. Now, the real estate, we are living in this city of Mumbai. And if you really see what is this city we are living in Mumbai, when a tourist comes to Mumbai, where will he go? Can you tell me where a tourist in Mumbai will go? A tourist has nothing. Where will he go? He will go to Juhu Beach. He will go to Tarapurwala Aquarium. After that, where will he go? He cannot go anywhere else. He will take a walk on Marine Drive. And after that, there is nothing in this city which can do anything. So the real estate industry is making so many buildings. All you have to do is just give a little thought to every building that you are building. Make every building a tourist attraction. Create a Buddha building. Add 10% extra cost to that. And create buildings which have a theme. Create a building which has some innovation in them. Every time, we don't have to create rectangle buildings. We can create buildings which are visually appealing. We can create buildings which have a theme inside that. And then the tourist will drive around the city of Mumbai, and he will see that the buildings of Mumbai itself are a tourist attraction. And the real estate industry has to apply little mind. They don't have to create buildings. They have to create ideas. They have to create idea where everyone wants to look at the idea, they want to understand the idea, and they want to go to the idea and they want to understand it. This is the way in which a real estate industry can boost the tourism of this city. And I would once more like to congratulate all the winners of the awards over here. And thank you for inviting me here, and my best wishes to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. If I may please request you to remain on the stage, sir. And I'm going to once again invite Mr. Anurag Batra to please come forward. Well, this is just our way of thanking the stalwarts as well as all the eminent people who are joining us this evening to thank them for their fantastic presence and for sharing their wonderful thoughts with all of us. So thank you once again. And as Mr. Batra says again, I'm going to inform you all, we don't have tax on clapping. Neither does the nation have any kind of a tax on clapping. So let's keep that momentum on.